Hello, thank you for joining me once again on the Basic Universal Statistics course. On today's video tutorial, we shall be looking at how to estimate and interpret single equation models in EViews. And this is the part one of this particular video episode. On the part two, we shall be going straight to hands-on. Okay, we need to understand basically what single equation model is. A model is single when only the independent variables affect the dependent, while the dependent variable does not in turn affect the independent variable. That is, a single equation model has only one dependent variable and one or more independent variables. To estimate this model, there are three forms of model specification to be employed. We have what we call the linear-linear model, the log-log model, also known as double-log model, and semi-log model. Okay, now looking at each of them here, we have a linear-linear model is specified when both the dependent and independent variables enter the equation without any log transformation. Example of such here, we have yt equals to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus the error term. Now, as you can see, the dependent variable here is yt and the independent variable here is xt. The coefficients here are b1 and b0. As you can see here, the b0 here represents the intercept, while the b1 here represents the coefficient. Now, as you can see here, the dependent and independent variable are not logged. Okay, as you can see here, both of them are not logged. So we'll call this a linear-linear model because they don't have any log transformation in them. Now, looking at log-log model or double-log model, a double-log model is specified when both sides of the equation are expressed in logarithmic form. That is, rather, this is usually done to ensure linearity of the model. It helps convert and integrate different values of a variable into a common denominator. Okay, it brings different units to a common base for measurement. And lastly, it ensures that the coefficients of the variables are used as elasticities to explain the response of a change in one variable with respect to another. Example of double log models as we have here. As you can see, both the dependent and independent variable are logged. Alright, so once you log the dependent and independent variable in your single equation model, we call it a double log model or log-log model. And last, we have what we call the semi-log model. A semi-log model is specified when there is partial logarithmic transformation of the series in the model. Okay, the model is particularly considered when dealing with series that can't be logged, such as negative rates or negative series. Example: fiscal deposit, net foreign direct investment, etc. And transform variables in rates. Example: growth rate, inflation rate, exchange rate, interest rate, etc. Okay, however, there are two forms of semi-log model. We have what we call the linear log model and log linear model. In a linear log model, the dependent variable remains the same, but the independent variable appears in logs. Example, as you can see here, the dependent variable is not logged, whereas the independent variable is logged. In this kind of model, we call it a linear log model. Linear log in the sense that the dependent variable is not logged, but the independent variable is logged. The other form is what we call log linear model. The dependent variable appears in log while the independent variable remains the same. Example of such is as we have here. The dependent variable is logged, whereas the independent variable here is not logged. So this kind of model is called a log linear model. Okay, now we'll look at how to interpret these kind of models in our equations. Remember, various scholars have difficulty interpreting some of their results, especially when they fail to account for how the unit of the measurement or how the variables were actually logged. So looking at this, we're going to explain them in detail. Starting with the linear-linear, we'll say here that a one unit change in xt, which is the independent variable, will lead to a b1, that is the coefficient of independent variable, unit change in the mean value of the dependent variable. As you can see, look at the linear-linear model here. We have the dependent variable yt, we have the independent variable here xt, as you can see. So interpretation goes that a unit change in xt, which is the independent variable, will lead to a b1, which is the coefficient of independent variable, unit change in the mean of yt. Suppose for a second that the values that we have here are in billions. Let's say the yt is in billion, while the xt is in billion. It simply means that a 1 billion change in the independent variable will lead to a b1, okay, multiply this, whatever value this b1 gives you, multiply by 1 billion, change in the mean value of yt, okay, which is a dependent variable. They also have the log-log, which is double log model. We say a 1% change in xt, which is the independent variable, will lead to a b1% change in the mean value of yt, which is the dependent variable, as you can see Both of them are logged. Okay, the dependent and independent variable are logged. So we'll call this a log-log model. So how to interpret it is a 1% change in xt, which is an independent variable, will lead to a b1, which is the coefficient of independent variable, percent change in the mean value of yt. They also have the linear log model. As you can see here, the linear, the dependent variable is not log, whereas the independent variable is log. How to interpret it is a 1% change in xt, which is the independent variable, will lead to a b1 divided by 100, that whatever the value of b1 is, you divide it by 100, you need change in the mean value of the dependent variable. Okay, and lastly, we have the log linear. How to interpret it is a one unit change in xt, which is the independent variable, will lead to a b1 multiplied by 100. So whatever the coefficient value of this x1 xt here is, you multiply it by 100, percent change in the mean value of yt, which is your dependent variable. And again, look at how to specify your log linear model. Okay, so basically, kindly take note of this. You can pause to read and understand how it is interpreted. In part two, we're going to go straight to the hands-on to show you how to do that practically. Okay, moving on, we'll have other aspects of the regression model. Here we have the coefficient output, the regression coefficient output. The column label coefficient depicts the estimated coefficient, okay, which is the beta here. The coefficient shows the sign and size or magnitude of change. They are computed by the standard ordinary least square formula. We also have the standard errors. Okay, the standard error column reports the estimated standard errors of the coefficients. The standard errors measures the statistical reliability of the coefficient estimate. The larger the standard errors, the more statistical noise in the estimate. Okay, we also have the t-statistics, which is part of the output of the regression of the single linear equation regression. The t-statistic, which is computed as the ratio of an estimated coefficient to its standard error, is employed to test the statistical significance of individual regression coefficients. To interpret the t-statistic, you should examine the probability value or p-value captured as prob. Usually when the result comes on, you see it as prob here, okay? It's also known as the probability value. Okay, coming down straight to what this probability value actually means. The probability value or marginal significance level is defined as the lowest significance level at which a null hypothesis can be rejected. Okay, it is defined as the lowest significance level at which a null hypothesis can be rejected. Given a p-value, you can tell at a glance if you are to reject or accept a null hypothesis at a glance. Okay, we also have how to determine the statistical significance of regression coefficient. Let's say we are looking at 5% level of significance. If the probability value of the t-statistic is greater than 0.05, we accept the null hypothesis, okay? And if the probability value of the t-statistic is less than 0.05, reject the null hypothesis. So basically, it's how to accept or reject your hypothesis at 5% level of significance, okay? Look at the decision rule here. If the probability value of the t-statistic is greater than 0.05, you accept the null hypothesis. And if the probability value of the t-statistic is less than 0.05, you reject the null hypothesis, that is at 5% level of significance, okay? Now, we also have what we call the summary statistics, starting with the R-squared. The R-squared is also known as the coefficient of determination, and it is used to measure the goodness of fit or explanatory power of a model. Technically, the R-squared gives the proportion or percentage of the total variation in the dependent variable that is explained by the regressors or the independent variables. Okay, we also have what we call the adjusted R squared. The adjusted R squared, okay, penalizes the R squared for addition of regressors which do not contribute to the explanatory power of the model. Meaning, whatever variables or independent variables that do not contribute to the explanatory power of the model, no matter how you increase it or how you increase such kind of variables in the model, the adjusted R squared will not improve if those variables does not contribute to the explanatory power of the model. So it adjusts whatever it is that does not contribute to the explanatory power of the model. And lastly, we have the Dobrowolski and the F statistic. The Dobrowolski statistic measures the evidence of autocorrelation in the residuals. Okay, basically it tells us if there is first order autocorrelation amongst our residual. Okay, the acceptable Dobrowolski range of no autocorrelation is between 1.5 and 2.0. If it lies outside this range, then there is a problem of autocorrelation. Okay, they also have the F statistic. The F statistic tells us the overall, okay, significance of the regression model. It tells us in general if all the variables in the model are statistically significant jointly. Okay, it tells us the overall significance of the regression model. So basically, this is how to interpret and explain single linear equation model. For the hands-on proper and how to carry it out with eViews, kindly watch out for the part two of this particular video episode. Okay, kindly watch out for the part two for the hands-on proper on how to estimate this practically using eViews. If this is the first time of coming to our channel to watch our video, kindly click the subscribe button to get more video updates on analysis, and kindly share this video with friends, academic or researchers that might have need for them for their academic and research purpose. Thank you for watching.